Welcome to a lesson on the medians of a triangle. The goals of this video are to define the medians of a triangle and then state the properties of the medians of a triangle. The median is a line segment that joins a vertex and the midpoint of the opposite side. So here we see a median in red. And since this is the midpoint of the opposite side, we know that this segment is congruent to this segment. And because each triangle has three vertices, every triangle also has three medians. And the point of concurrency of the three medians is called the centroid. So in this diagram, this point here is the centroid. It's the point where all three medians intersect. The centroid is also the center of mass of an object of uniform density in the shape of a triangle, which means the object would balance on any line through the centroid. The way I like to think about this is, if this triangle was a piece of sheet metal with uniform density, and you place it horizontally, let's say this was the centroid, if you put the tip of a rod on the centroid underneath this piece of sheet metal, it would balance perfectly horizontally on that rod. Now let's take a look at the concurrency of medians theorem. The medians intersect in a point that is two-thirds the distance from the vertices to the midpoint of the opposite side. And we now know that point is the centroid. So if we take a look at the median CD, if we know the length is 27 units, CM would be two-thirds the total distance. Well, two-thirds of 27 would be 18. Leaving one-third of the distance for the segment MD, and that would be 9. So this is another property that this theorem tells us. So if we know that segment AE has a length of 15 units, then AM would be two-thirds of 15, that would be 10. Leaving one-third the total length for ME, so that'd be 5. And if we know the median BF is 12 units, here in green, well, two-thirds of 12 would be 8. So this would be 8 units, two-thirds of 12, and this would be one-third of 12, which would give us 4. Let's go ahead and state this more formally. AM would be two-thirds of AE, and ME would be one-third of AE. There's also one more connection that we can make. If we compare AM and ME, notice that ME is half the length of AM. And this property will also always hold true. Hopefully that makes sense. If AM is two-thirds AE and ME is one-third AE, ME is always going to be half of AM. And we can state the same properties for each median. If we take a look at the median CD, here in orange, CM is going to be two-thirds CD. And MD will be one-third CD. And again, it follows that MD will be one-half of CM. Let's go and take a look at the last median in green, BF. BM will be two-thirds BF, so MF will be equal to one-third BF. And then finally, MF will be one-half of BM. I think we'll go ahead and stop here on this video. I hope you found this helpful.